This place can get downright loud when the roof is closed, and that's the situation here today at NRG Stadium in Houston, Texas. The scene from a few moments ago, this crowd enthusiastically cheering on their Texans as they emerge from the locker room, and we're just about ready for football as the Texans get set to match up with the Buffalo Bills. First carry for Carlos Hyde. And right away, they're going to stack him up right at the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain on the game's first play. And it's second down now. The defensive line made pretty easy work of the offensive line that time.
And people get tired of the cliche that the battle is won in the trenches. But it's a cliche because it's true. And how about the battle right there? One on the edge, and the ball carrier did not benefit.
And now the throw going to Fuller, and he's got it. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down.
The goal for any offense versus a zone defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. An early test for this defense. Here we go on third and inches. Now it's Watson, a bootleg. And he's got the completion to Hopkins. Look at this, middle of the field, a breakaway. Touchdown, Houston. DeAndre Hopkins, 66 yards, as his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter. I know this defense knew it coming into the game, Charles, and they know it even more now. DeAndre Hopkins is a tough cover.
And anytime you see him out there and there's less than double or triple teaming him, take a shot with it. Just what you're talking about. If he's such a tough cover, one guy's not going to get it done. Throw the ball out there, let him go get it.
So after the touchdown, here's Fairbairn now to kick it away. This is taken at the three. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. The Bills offense coming out, ready to take over. Allen and the Bills now with a first and 10 at their own 23. Now the first carry here for Frank Gore. Bradley Roby, the quarterback, there to make the stop.
Not much happening there on first down.
I thought there might have been a hole for a split second.
Yeah, but it dried up pretty quickly, didn't it? Closed fast.
Second down, this is Gore. Gore, a first down and then some. And he's going to be out up around the 45-yard line. 19 yards the pick up there. Move the chains. Couple of very nice carries to start this drive out.
Yeah, two first downs. And how about that second one? What a nice run on that particular play. I'm telling you, they're going to start to think that this game is easy if they continue to rip off yardage like this.
Stepping up, he's going to keep it. Give him three on the keeper there, and it is second down.
And that's one of the reasons you like to blitz even on rundowns. It confuses the blocking assignments. It doesn't allow those offensive linemen to get up to the second level.
On second down now, Gore. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of two, now third down. Plays like we just saw there. That's why they're up right now. And the defense, they're doing their job.
Yeah, it starts with the guys up front. So when you talk with GMs who are putting together a team, a lot of them say, we're going to build from the inside out. Because if you control the line of scrimmage, you control the rest of the ball game. And that's what we're seeing here. They're actually playing in the offense's backfield, not necessarily just playing at the line of scrimmage.
Now a shot taken on third down, but it's going to wind up incomplete.
And third down is a key down in any game you play. And third down defense, something we've got to watch in this one. Got to be effective on the passing downs. That's a pretty good first step right there.
On fourth down, on is Corey Bohorquez to punt. DeAndre Carter is deep for the Texans. It's a 40-yard punt, 4 yards on the return. And the Texans are going to have the football with a first and 10 deep in their own territory. Out comes the Houston offense as they get set to take over here. And certainly they'll be hoping to hit pay dirt like they did on the last drive. Got the football back, so a chance to go up 2 scores.
And they haven't been tentative at all in this ball game, because sometimes you start a game with your script to try and get information out of the opposing defense. How will they play you in certain situations? Sometimes you script to attack. And that's what I'm seeing so far.
7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
Fired that one in there, able to make connection on a nice in route.
With those faster passes when they're going that fast, any hesitation, deflection if you miss might be bigger and lead to an interception?
Yeah, and the deflection works both ways. Maybe a defender gets a hand in the way and it pops in the air. And sometimes you throw it so hard your receiver can't handle it, and he pops it up in the air for the defenders to grab as well.
But a moot point there as they were able to connect. They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete. Before the game, they were running the route tree about as efficiently and effectively as we could have possibly imagined, but sometimes the passes just go awry.
Yeah, let's face it. When you're running the route tree in pregame, you don't have defenders breathing down your neck. You don't have defensive backs making plays on the football. Hard to replicate the intensity of the game in pregame.
He's got his tight end. It's Fells. They stop him for only 3 that time, and that'll bring up fourth down.
That was a nice throw out there to the flat, but they defended that pretty well. The hope is to go ahead and put it on him so he can turn and get upfield and gain additional yardage. There just wasn't anywhere to go on that play.
On fourth down, here's Brian Anger now to kick this one away. Andre Roberts is deep for Buffalo. Oh, good move. 12 yards on the return that time. And the Bills will take over the football with a first and 10. Here's the Buffalo offense now as they get set to take over here. The crowd may be losing just a little bit of the edge after back-to-back punts.
They want some big plays. They want to see some offense. They want to see somebody break away, whether it's through the air or on the ground. Now it'll be interesting to see where the patience is on both sides. Each head coach, can you hang in there and not try and force something that could put your team in some jeopardy?
12 yards that time and a Bills first down.
Well, they obviously red man covers their partner, and he got downfield, broke down the defender, made him
think.
What
do you mean by that?
He made him think he was going to run a different route. Probably thought he was going to take it upfield, and then he curls back inside for the completion.
Allen now on first down. The throw on target to his receiver, McKenzie. He'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. That's a good chunk of yardage that's going to be canceled out.
And we always talk about hidden yardage in a game. That's going to count as that, because now it doesn't go on the books, but now they have to make that up again, don't they?
So following the hold, they're in a bit of a hole here with a first and 20. From the gun, it's Allen. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. That's a gain of 11. Would have been a first down if not for that penalty moments ago. On second down, Gore. Only a yard on the pickup, and now they've got a third down and 8.
We've called a lot of games, but we don't normally talk about inside linebackers being that fleet of foot, do we?
No, he was able to get outside there to make that play.
Yeah, and you know what makes them faster? Their ability to read plays, understand what offenses are trying to do, and put themselves in proper position.
Throwing is Allen on third. They'll roll him out right. He may try and run for this. And he'll be brought down with the first down and a late flag here, too. And he may get a few more tacked on for good measure. So that flag will cost him 15.
And it doesn't matter anymore how you get the face mask. Any part of it, that's going to be 15 yards.
So the face mask, quite a blessing there as they'll start out of harm's way with a first and 10. Following the penalty, it's Gore. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up second down.
Came out in a power set, but that only served to put more men in the box. And guess what? If you're going to do that, you've got to win up front, right? Your offensive guys have got to beat the defenders. They lost all leverage on that play.
On second down now, Gore. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there. Let's go. Watch tight end.
We got three. They'll try and pick up the first with Gore. And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. No gain there on the play, and that's going to leave him with a fourth down. So off goes Allen, and on comes Steven Hauschka for the Buffalo field goal. And the 11-year veteran bangs it through, and they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So they put together a good little drive there, but ultimately stalling out in the red zone.
Yeah, I know a lot of people look at it as a little bit of a negative. They didn't get 6 points out of it, right? Didn't get the touchdown. But that's actually okay. They got 3 points, able to give their defense a little bit of rest, let them settle down over there. So all in all, to me, that's a good drive.
Now after the made field goal, Hauschka back out of the field to kick it away. This is taken at the 3. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. Heading out is the Texans offense as they get set to take over here. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Well, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. And he held on to it, but he probably shouldn't have as they get him behind the line. And that play there, boy, almost looked like it was a video game and he didn't know what the pitch button was. Not very well executed.
Yeah, and if you don't know what it is, you better figure it out fast. I suggest knowing it before you actually run that play.
On second and 11 now. Watson, and now he'll tuck it and run. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
It's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. Only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
They'll come up now on a second and long after the hold.
On the Army. Watch the safety creep.
Stepping up, he's going to keep it. Only a yard there on the keeper, and that's going to leave him with a third down.
Well, they had that one sniffed out. Excellent run blitz. Stopped that one for a short gain.
What makes a good run blitz a good run blitz?
The ability to stay on task, to follow up your assignment, go to the gap you're supposed to cover, and not be deterred by anything else.
Third and long, it's Watson. It's complete to Hopkins. And they work this well upfield across the 45. A very well-executed play. It goes for 29 yards. On that catch, he's already eclipsed 100 yards here in the first quarter. Charles, he's on pace for over 400.
And playing with great confidence, isn't he? I think he probably had it coming into the game, and now that he's really come out of the gate this strongly, how'd you like to be in the huddle with him right now? You know he's demanding the football. And guess what? I'd throw it to him. He's having a fantastic game, and they haven't defended him yet.
A pickup of 11 and a Texans first down. So first and 10 now in Buffalo territory at the 42-yard line. Johnson. And not a lot of daylight, not really any daylight inside. Second down. And he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
Yeah, it was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just zoom, quick, quick, quick. And what a terrific play, holding them to no gain.
Looking to throw on second down. Watson, he finds Hopkins complete. And he's going to get this inside the 30. And he's got a first down as the tackle made at the Bills' 26.
Now that was pretty. They executed that curl route versus zone coverage. And that changes things a little bit because against man, it's often a tight curl, tight, sharply run route. Again, zone, you're just looking for that open spot, that dead area. So you may curl it a little bit wider just to get to that place.
And usually a tight window. He fired a bullet in there for the completion. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. And this should be the final play before the quarter ends. On second and 12, Watson. And he's going to have the hook up to QT. And he'll be taken down as that will take us to the end of the first quarter of play. After one, 7-3 the score on EA Sports. The Texans on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This will be 3rd and 6. From the gun, here's Watson. And a catch made by Hopkins. What a methodical drive this is turning out to be. That time 9 yards, and the sticks move again. Well, they've had a great, impressive drive going here, and that pickup ensures the drive continues.
And not only do you continue the drive, which is demoralizing for the guys on the defensive side of the ball right now, but you make your own defense happy. They're able to get a little more rest over on the sidelines while this one continues downfield.
This will be caught at about the 5. And the result here, a pickup of 8, leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
In so many ways, throwing the hitch route is actually one of the safer things an offense can do. Get the ball out to the receiver as fast as possible, hope he's got man-to-man coverage, and hope that his athleticism wins on the perimeter.
Facing a 2nd and 2 after that last catch, good for 8 yards. Now a 2nd down throw for the end zone, but it's incomplete. DeAndre Hopkins once again the intended target, and it's 3rd and short. That is the first time that they've targeted him that he has not come down with a catch.
He's caught everything that's been thrown his way, a dominant pass receiver that can break down any defense, because when he's doing that kind of work, it really hurts you on the back end.
And even though it's an incompletion there, I think they're going back to that well. Incomplete, but a penalty flag is down in the backfield. Let's get the call. So following the holding call, what can they do here on 3rd and long? Watson looks to throw again. This is caught. And he can't quite get there. Tackled down at the 1. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal.
And in a lot of ways, that catch is expected. Red zone presence, and that one was realized there. You've got to find your tight end in that situation.
So another 3rd down conversion, and now they've got a 1st and goal. Again, it's Watson. That is caught. Hopkins for the Texans touchdown. Let's go, DeAndre Hopkins with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Texans push further out in front. And it was a tight window. He knew he had to rocket that thing in there. He got it done.
And when you're able to complete one like that, your confidence has to just go sky high. You just mentioned it. Tight window, zings it in there despite excellent coverage. Result, touchdown.
Fairbairn good with the extra point, and that pushes the lead up to 11. So after the touchdown, here's Fairbairn now to kick it away. This will be fielded at the 6. They'll bring it back to just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line. Back onto the field now comes the Bills offense. Their deficit is 11, 14-3, and needing to get something going here as they come up on 1st and 10. Allen and the Bills now with a 1st and 10 at their own 24. Trying to run inside, but nothing there. No gain there as he kept it himself at 2nd down. Well, they had the run for no gain. Now they'll try again from the 25 on 2nd and 10. Now this time, Allen will throw. He'll run it. He'll be dropped after a gain of about 6 across the 30 to the 31. The Bills on 3rd down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 4. So the shotgun snap to Allen. And this is going to be incomplete. Fair to say, hasn't been his best game throwing the football, but also not getting a lot of help out there either.
Yeah, you nailed it pretty well, you know. He's got to throw it better, got to get more help. Obviously one that should have been caught. They've got to find a way to bring those two elements together so they can make some progress in this one.
And the punt team on now as this one's sent away. On the return, Carter. 45 yards, that's what the punt goes for. 5 on the return. And the Texans will take over with a 1st and 10. And now out comes Houston. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were competent enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away. One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size, of these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense because you're excited about hitting him in the first half. Maybe not so much in the second half, and some of these shorter gains turn into bigger runs later.
And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a 1st down.
At this stage of the game, the run-pass numbers are a little bit out of whack because most of the yardage has come through the air. But in a sense, that just sets things up for big runs like that because the defense might be a little bit off balance. They pick up another 1st down with that run.
First down, a run with Hyde. And this play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38. It's a loss of 2 there, bringing up 2nd down.
Early down stuff to put this offense in a precarious position. We know that securing the point of attack, especially against the big-bodied guys in the middle of this D, has got to be priority 1. I got it.
second and 12. Watson, Hopkins on the grab over the middle. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down.
He decided to run a hitch route. It really helped to have a guy who can turn it loose. And, boy, he rifled one in there on that one. Not much run after catch, but it worked really well.
The Texans on third down. They've been near perfect. 4 for 5 to this point. This is 3rd and 7. A shotgun snap for Watson. Finding fouls complete. Now he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. And he's got a first down as a tackle made at the Bills' 32-yard line. And with that completion, he's now north of 200 yards here in the first half. Boy, a tough start for the secondary defensively.
It is, and it's got to put a dent in their confidence. And, you know, you always want to keep that up and feel like you can always bounce back after plays. But with the kind of numbers he's putting up here, it's starting to wear on them a little bit, I think. So they're looking at each other and trying to figure out what defense will work and how can they play better without getting beat deep for big passes. It is hard in zone coverage to stop a curl route because when they see it, they just try and find the open spot and sit down.
Yeah, we always talk about finding the soft spot in the zone. What's the key to doing that? How do you do it?
You have to read what the coverage is. Is it 2 deep? Is it 3 deep? Because then you know where the linebackers are going to drop, what spots in the field they naturally get to, and you find that open space, and then you're in sync with your quarterback. He should be reading the exact same thing, and they put the ball right on you.
They'll get 3 as the drive continues. It's a first down.
What is that? 18? Right, 58, right there. Double dog. That's the way.
From the red zone now, Watson. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
That's very well timed there defensively because it's not a bad throw, but the collision came at the exact time he was reaching to bring in the football. Really, really well done.
Decent offense, just better defense. I think you're right. After the incompletion, here's 2nd and 10 from the 20. Throwing again is Watson. Open man, the tight end fails. And he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down.
And, partner, I think that was a great example that not all tight ends are created equal because everything was right. Got the completion, but he's not one of the more dynamic guys in the league. So even though he caught it, couldn't turn it into much more.
Throwing on third down, Watson. That is caught inside the 5. And he couldn't quite get there. Tackled down at the 1. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a 1st and goal.
I think it all came together there. In-breaking route, drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
Now a play fake, and it's Watson. And he's going to go down just outside of the 5, right around the 6-yard line. That sack by Tremaine Edmonds.
Well, surprise, surprise. 1st and goal at the 1. No quarterback sneak. No running play. They decide to throw for it, but the pressure got to him quickly and put the quarterback down.
2nd and goal from the 6 this time. They'll fake the handoff. Now Watson. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Micah Hyde. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Well, CD, earlier we looked at the AFC playoff picture. Let's quickly peek at what's going on in the NFC right now. We mentioned Seattle and New Orleans would get the byes if the season ended today. The matchups, though, first round wild card weekend would be San Fran and Dallas and Minnesota and Green Bay. I smell ratings, my friend.
Big time ratings. Let's start with Minnesota and Green Bay because that would be their 3rd meeting of the year as they are division rivals in the NFC North. And, of course, going to Lambeau anytime after October 15 is dicey with weather, so you don't know what you're going to get. Minnesota now a dome team. How about San Francisco at Dallas? You could potentially have a San Francisco team with 12 or more wins going on the road to take on a division champ, the NFC East, Dallas, that may have 8 wins. Doesn't seem right, doesn't seem fair, but that's the system. San Francisco may very well have to do it.
Game clock at 2:01. Time for one final play before the two-minute warning. Now on third and two, they're going to elect to throw with Allen. And able to find John Brown. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Working out of the shotgun, here's Allen. Open man, here's Foster. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. 15 yards that time, and a Buffalo first.
I know you're trying not to scoreboard watch, but you only got 3 points. You're kind of hoping that that type of play there gives you some positive momentum going into the half.
Yeah, I need to do something to get more than that three number that they have on the scoreboard right now. First down, and they're going to throw it down. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
The beauty of being able to play a zone defense, when you can sit back and see the ball coming out of the quarterback's hands, guess what? Creates a lot of confusion, kind of a muddle in the middle of the field where you can go make a play on the football.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Allen now to throw again. And a quick throw here, that's complete. The reception good for 7. It's third down.
It's easy work, and it's coming again.
They'll get to the line here, but remember, it's also third down. Allen to throw once more. And that's knocked away and incomplete. Jonathan Joseph there on the coverage.
They went with the dime look that time on defense. Just flooded the field with defensive backs. Blanketed everyone. Took away all the passing angles. Thus, the incompletion.
The Bills send the punter out as he'll come on to kick this one away. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. And this one hits at the one, continues on into the end zone for a touchback. Now the Texans offense, they head back out to do battle here. Still more than a minute to go, so there is time if they want to mount something here.
Not only time, but they have 3 timeouts at their disposal as well. So that changes everything that you're doing here. Without those timeouts, you can only work the sidelines, hoping to get out of bounds. Here, the middle of the field is still available because you can call timeout and regroup.
He's going to take off with it. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. Now the Texans will burn the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. Up at the 29 now, they'll head to the line, second and a yard. Here's Watson. He gets this one to Johnson. Now the Texans will use one of their 2 remaining timeouts as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. They had the catch on second down, but it didn't help at all. And now they're looking at third down here. Out of the gun, Watson. He's got his tight end. It's Fells. And he's able to get it to the 31, and that's enough for the first. Give him 3 yards and a fresh set of downs.
At first glance, I thought he just used his size in order to win the route. But he also had a little subtle move in there as well. Made the defender think he was going one direction and was able to track the ball in another.
Now it's Watson. He finds his man, Johnson. They'll give him a yard on the play, and that'll bring up second down. They only got a yard out of that last completion, and that makes this 2nd and 9. To the air yet again, Watson. It's complete to Hopkins. The reception good for seven. It's third down. The Texans going to signal for their third and final timeout as the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go here in the first half. And I see an extra defensive back on the field. Little surprise here on third and one. Watson now to throw. Over the middle, it's Fowles. He'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. So much for the run on third and one. Instead, it's a big chunk in the pass game. First down. We have hit halftime. Still two more quarters to go. We'll take a timeout. We'll be back after this. You're watching the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. It's in the game. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. This will be taken in at the one. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. Out come the Bills now as they'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
But
this is a real, I'm doing it then. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. After the pickup of five, here's second and five. Back to the ground, this time with Gore. It'll be a pickup of a couple, and it leaves him with a third and three. He really hasn't been able to get on track running the football, averaging less than 4 yards a carry.
Yeah, I think that they're going to enjoy the film session because all the defenders are filling their proper gaps on just about every play. And you know what they always say for a defensive coach? When I click off this film, I better see 11 jerseys in the picture going after the ball carrier.
He gets it to Brown, complete. And he will have a first down here at about the 40. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
On first down, it's Gore. Now he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. You know, despite the scoreline, I think they've got to like where they are here. They're on the road and just one big play away from getting right back in this game.
I'm going to follow right along with you because the spot they're in now is a credit to their defense. They've kept them in it by making the plays that they've made, and that just means you're one big score away from being right back there.
Now, the question is, can this offense step up and make that play? Because that's been an issue for them in this game.
Well, if you do read man coverage, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people on it.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. From the gun, it's Allen. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. 10 yards, good enough for a Buffalo first down. And just in general, Charles, on a play like that, how tough is it for the defense to account for a running back essentially being a receiver downfield?
It's very difficult, especially if the running back has skills like a receiver, and you're aware of that before the game even begins. So throughout your practice sessions, you're going to want to be aware of him. Where is he lining up? What can he do? What kind of damage can he do to us downfield? And who can match up with him without weakening our overall defense? You're exactly right. It's a tough task to match up to him.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Now Allen throwing again. And he finds Beasley, complete. 11 yards and a Buffalo first down. Allen now Five straight completions here in this second half. First and 10. On the counter. Gore. And tough sledding. He'll get maybe a yard. Stop short of the 35.
Tough day. Tough sledding right there. And it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. On second and 9. Allen looking middle, and it's incomplete. Robert Foster, the intended receiver, third down here.
I know coaches tell us all the time that having a powerful arm isn't the number one thing they look for in a quarterback. But when you're trying to throw inside routes and you need to put some heat on it, it helps have the big gun. In this case, just a little bit too much.
After an incomplete pass on second down, that'll leave him trying to convert on third and 9. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down.
Well, how about that? A dime set on defense. Six defensive backs. None of them blitz. They're just back there in coverage. Defensive lineman gets the sack.
That's where the O-line, they go to the sideline. They keep their helmets on so the cameras can't find them, right?
Yeah, the cameras can't find them, but I know one thing. The O-line coach will.
Oh, and what a play on special teams here. This is going to be down inside the 5, all the way down at the 2-yard line.
And he's got to be fired up about that effort. I don't think he could have walked down and placed it any better than where he ended up putting the football. That was excellent.
Extra set. 19. It's our time. It's our time.
And I'm up. They'll try to get the offense going with Johnson. And I don't know if he made it out of the end zone. No signal. Yes, it's a safety. Well, I think you can go ahead and give your punter an assist on that one. Pinned him deep, and the defense comes through with 2 points.
You're exactly right, partner. This was all set up by a great punt, and if the ball goes in the end zone, this never happens. So great call. Give the punt team and the punter some love.
So after that safety, now a free kick situation forthcoming as they punt it away from the 20. Taken in at the 22. Now the Bills offense gets ready to head back onto the field. And down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football.
Sense of urgency has to take over for them here. They know the score. They know the situation. And by the way, the punter no longer exists for their offense. That's how they have to treat this drive.
They need points.
Big time.
Allen gonna throw. Got a man. It's Brown. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable second and 1. Now it's Gore. And an alley to run. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. Give him 18 on that one as the Bills are going to have a first down.
They were not fooling around at all, were they? Second and short, and they brought out the heavy package. Almost felt like the super heavy package against that defense, didn't it?
Yeah, I don't think they expected that much beef up front, and it turned into an easy first down conversion. Gore again here on first down. And he's taken down inside the 30. 11 yards and a Buffalo first down.
Despite the score, despite the deficit, no quitting this guy. He's running angry, running through arm tackles. He wants to change what that scoreboard is saying.
Mike, 65.
Here's Allen on first and 10. And he finds Tyler Croft. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
Right there.
That's a staple of this offense, drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
Inside 4 minutes to go, third quarter. Stepping up, he'll try and run, and they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. That one, a first down pickup of 8. And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gut.
And he's a guy that has some height to him. So when you don't have to drop a shoulder or create or get through contact or trash, makes it a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make a run as we just saw there.
They'll run on first down. Gore. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. A loss of 2 there. Second down.
Perfectly designed blitz right there. They took that one from the grease board to the field because they were able to free up their linebacker to get into the backfield and spill the play.
A rare misstep on that last play because the drive has been strong, but now it's second and 12. Back to the workhorse today. It's Gore. And he'll get 4 there, down to about the 12-yard line.
Well, if you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
Now play number 7 of this drive, but it's a tough 3rd and 9. So the shotgun snap to Allen, sliding out of the pocket. He can run for it, and he will. And he'll be tackled right on the 10, well short of the first down. Only able to get back a yard for his efforts, and that leads us to 4th down.
Well, partner, nothing comes open here, so he decides to escape out of there, and he doesn't pick up a first down, but he does gain additional yardage to set up a possible field goal attempt if they decide to go that route.
And Hauschka's kick is good. And high fives for that one as that drive ends in 3. So the scoring drive encompasses 9 plays, and the net result, 3 points.
Take your disappointment and put it aside. 9 plays, yeah, they want to end up in the end zone with a touchdown. I get that. But sometimes those 9-play drives pay dividends later with another 9-play drive that culminates in a touchdown when they wear down a defense.
Now after the made field goal, Hauschka back out onto the field to kick it away. This will be taken in at the 1. He's going to be stopped here with a penalty marker on the field. I'm not sure what this is about. Officials so cognizant of that call nowadays, but that one looked pretty easy.
Yeah, you're right. They took out of their hands having to wonder whether it's a 5-yard or a 15-yard inadvertent or not. Now it's a lot easier. You see it, you call it.
And now it's 1st and 10, a big mistake, especially when you factor in the personal foul yardage. Running from the gun, Johnson. And an alley to run. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. A fresh set of downs on a gain of 13 there for the Texans.
On any explosive run, you can almost feel the ground shaking, and that's from the offensive linemen creating space for their runners. I had an old coach tell me before that he always told his runners, run around the offensive line in pregame. Get used to the ground shaking so you don't trip and fall when it happens in a game.
Back to the ground. This time it's high, and he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. A pickup of 11 at a Texans first down. Good push up front in that run in between the tackles.
Let's play the leverage game here. Offensive line just got lower than the defensive front, and they are able to get their pads on them and move them backwards and create space for their running back to roam.
On first down, it's Watson. Open man is QT, complete. And this time not quite to the 30. It'll be down at the 31-yard line. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up 2nd down. Second and 5 after the 5-yard completion on first down. Going to run the sweep here. This is Hopkins. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. The tally there, minus 2 yards, brings up third down. Got to get to the 26 for a first. This is third down. From the gun, here's Watson. He finds Hopkins complete. And they'll get him down about 3 yards short of the first. They stop him for only three that time, and that'll bring up fourth down.
One of the money routes for any offense, the drag route. So tough to defend because the receiver can stop at any point and make himself available to the quarterback and get a completion. But I love the communication we saw there. All the defenders pointing out the receiver, where he was going, and then they're able to rally to the ball after the catch and stop him short of a first down.
A big one there. That gives him a little cushion and makes it a two-score game.
Yeah, bled a little time off the clock, put some points on the board. It's not totally out of reach yet, but it has to feel pretty good to them right now because as a defender, you go out on the field and say, guess what? You can put some points on the board, but that won't beat us.
Fairbairn now following the made field goal. He'll send this one away. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. And now out come the Bills. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 point.
The kicker.
Exactly. He put it through the post. That's going to help him at contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that'll help him at contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that.
Toe bash.
I don't know about
toe
that.
Bash.
Super toe.
And he'll be brought down somewhat awkwardly here. A late flag as well. I think this one's going to be a face mask. Here's the Buffalo offense now as they get set to take over here. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
That throw good for four. It's second down.
I think it's okay there. They didn't get a whole lot on that play. But it's nice to have a safety valve that's built like this guy. Big target, guy you can spot pretty easily. Put it on him when your other targets aren't open.
4 yards on that last completion, so that sets up second and six. Here's Allen to throw it. And he's going to have the connection to Foster. And he's going to be taken down with another first down as the stop's made at the Texans' 38-yard line.
One of the selling points at the in route is it gives the quarterback a really nice sight line to his receiver and almost on a direct shot, able to throw the ball into the middle of the field and have a great chance of success as they did on that play.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Throwing now is Allen. Looking for his running back, and he's got him. Just a 1 yard pickup on the play, and it'll be a second down. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. You're tackling them almost on the spot. That means you have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
Throwing again on second down, Allen. And that'll be incomplete. Good protection that time, and they couldn't hook up on the long one. Now it's third down.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. The Bills on third down. They're right at about the league average, 40%, 4 for 10. This is third and 9. Here's Allen, and that is incomplete.
But plain and simple, that's the second time today that he's dropped a pass.
And that one, I think, maybe even a little easier than the earlier one that he dropped. Surprising.
Was this game announced as a night game prior to, and maybe his rhythm is just off? He's got thrown off. He's going to have to wake up, enjoy the sunshine, and go play.
And this is good. It was running out of gas there at the end, but he winds up getting just enough on it. And the drive will wind up yielding three. All right, so they needed two scores to get back in the game. The field goal there, maybe not exactly what they wanted, but the necessary first step.
There's still time remaining, and there's enough time to get it done. They've got to get at the least a three and out here to get the ball back, preferably a takeaway.
Now after the made field goal, Hauschka back out onto the field to kick it away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. Out comes the Houston offense as they get set to take over here. The field goal we just saw has this now at a one-score game. And on this side of the football, things are getting pretty tenuous, a little stressful.
Blood pressure up a little bit, you think?
I think up a lot of it.
Could you imagine taking the pulse right now? Might be like a jackhammer out there on that side of the ball. But here's what the deal is. I think what we've observed is a team that's been playing not to lose.
The ball's out. Hyde fumbled it. Now this is picked up by the Bills. And they will take over at the 26-yard line. Here's Allen following the fumble recovery, rolling to his right. The improv on the scramble there gets him six, and it'll be second down.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
Allen off the play fake. Open man here is Foster. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
A little football 101 there. You just see the receiver try to run down the defender, meaning he goes right at him and really trying to move him a little bit towards the center of the field so he can put his foot in the ground and break to the out to the sideline and make a catch.
They'll run on first down with Singletary. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
On second and nine, Allen. This will be caught just inside the 10. It'll be a 2-yard gain, and that's going to lead to a third down. And they're left looking at third and eight after the second down pass play only went for two. Working out of the shotgun, here's Allen. Looking in zone, but it's incomplete. I guess they're in a situation now, fourth quarter, where they're forced to take some chances, but I don't know that that was the type of a chance you want to take.
And that one could very easily have been intercepted, and if it does get picked off, that could possibly seal this one.
So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. From the left hash, a chip shot here. Hauschka's kick is good, and high fives for that one as that drive ends in three. So with that field goal, this one's now back within a field goal. Maybe not the ultimate result they wanted, but gets them that much closer.
This game is unfolding like a really good book, isn't it? Because I feel like there's a few more plot twists yet to be revealed before this one is over.
Now after the made field goal, Hauschka back out onto the field to kick it away. This is fielded at the goal line. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line.
Let's go.
Here comes the Texans now. Yeah, last drive, obviously not what you're looking for. You've got the lead. You've got to protect the football.
So in other words, someone got lucky because they've been moving the ball really well and wearing them down. In this case, though, giving up the football doesn't make them very happy. They can't wait to get back out there and atone for it.
Yeah, try to atone for it here on this drive. They start the drive with Hyde. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
All right, that's a decent game there, but it hasn't been his best game overall. So I wonder what the mindset is of his team. Do they want him to handle the football and try and close this game out? Or are they going to make an alternative plan and maybe go in a different direction?
I think they need him, and this is his time to shine. They run it again with Hyde. And he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line. That'll be a loss of a yard, and it leads to a third down.
Now, obviously, that's some good work there defensively, being able to stop them and bringing up a key third down. But if you're on the offensive side of the ball, there's an opportunity, because I know what defensive guys are thinking right now. Just stop them, get to the ball. That means they might not be sound defensively. There could be some opportunities.
And you said key third down. Highlight that word. Put it in bold. Here we go. And he's got a first down as a tackle made at the Bills' 45-yard line. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
So first and 10 now in Buffalo territory at the 45-yard line. 2 yards the gain on the keeper, and it's second down.
Anytime you decide to use your quarterback as a runner, most of the time when you design a play, you're expected to break a little bit bigger than this one, because when you run him on short gains, your risk reward and him taking hits, I'm not sure that's the payoff they were looking for.
On second down, Johnson. And he'll be close to a first down as the tackle made at the Bills 36.
So much of the game today, we're looking for hybrid players, guys who can do a combination of jobs. And anyone who plays a strong safety position, now more than ever, is a hybrid type player. Half defensive back that covers passes and half linebacker that makes tackles. We just saw the linebacker make that play.
And Hyde will not get there as they force him to the ground, shy of the marker. Call it no gain that time, and they're going to be left looking up at a fourth and one. Seems pretty obvious defensively a key was stopping the run game. How have they done it so successfully?
To me, it seems that these guys really did a nice job of paying attention during the scouting report meeting. And you know, Brandon, when they do those, they talk about the top plays that these guys like to run. The best runs for the top running back. Those are the ones you focus on and want to take away. And they've done that pretty successfully in this game.
Now listen, now no kick from 50 plus is a gimme, but here you're indoors in a dome, you'd think ideal conditions.
Yeah, and it's one that he would expect himself to make, not just us expecting him to make it. Over the years, my theory is very simple. The athletic ability of kickers continues to get better and better. Check their background. They were all county, all state, and other positions, not just soccer players. These guys expect themselves to be great as well.
So a nice job to break the one tackle, but not much daylight after that as he's brought down. That first down completion only netted him 3. Second and 7. Now Allen. This will be caught by Brown. And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
Well, that's what you're looking for when you're wanting to throw the ball downfield. You want one of those guys who can play out on the perimeter, can play out wide, who can not only get open, but when they're covered, can uncover themselves downfield and create catches.
Allen now on first down. Got an open man. It's Foster. And all the way home for a Bills touchdown. Robert Foster. 45 yards, and the Bills have taken the lead. And correct me if I'm wrong, that was just a simple fly route, wasn't it?
No, there's nothing to correct at all. You've got it down pat. And I just remember as a player, when I'd be in practice sessions and I'd hear 9 from the receivers, that meant fly route, go, look out. That was the 9, and he just kept going all the way into the end zone for the touchdown.
Hauschka now to send this one away following the score. This will be taken in at the 1. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. The Texans offense now, they get set to head back onto the field. Watson will bring up the Texans here, first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. A shotgun snap for Watson. Got an open man, it's QT. A pickup of 11 and a Texans first down. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Out of the gun, Watson. And he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down.
No doubt that's a very good play defensively right there, because you've always got to be aware that he can take off and make a big play with his legs. How about the way they were able to contain him? That also tells me the coverage was excellent downfield.
They don't need to run another play here before the 2-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. After the sack on first down, Watson, his throw incomplete. Duke Johnson, the one he was looking for. And that'll make it third down.
Certainly looked like maybe his third or his fourth read on his progression. Just trying to find his outlet man that time. Ends up leading him just a bit too much.
Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. From the gun, Watson. Complete, it's Johnson. Down 4 late, gotta go for it here on fourth down. They will indeed snap it to Watson. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And that is incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And the Bills are going to take over in excellent field position. And he'll have a tough time living that one down. It's one thing, Charles, to drop a pass. It's quite another to drop it on fourth down.
And so many teams work on that in terms of locking in on those key downs. You know, I've seen, you know, you and I have both been to practices where we've seen, hey, third down situation, big third down alert, lock in here. Fourth down play, make sure you focus just a little bit extra. It didn't pay off in that situation.
Here's the Buffalo offense now as they get set to take over here. And this one now not quite over yet. Still 2 timeouts remaining defensively. And boy, having that third timeout would have really helped here.
Another example of why coaches really stress saving your timeouts for when you absolutely have to have them. They go over this all the time. Here's one of those situations.
Here's Gore. He'll get the first down and more inside the 20. Now the Texans will use one of their 2 remaining timeouts, and they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. A not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. Back to throw. Allen, he'll buy some time right. And now he's going to use his legs. The Texans going to signal for their third and final timeout as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. So Allen's going to look to throw. And this is caught. And that could seal it. It's a touchdown. There was no going through the progressions on that touchdown pass.
Yeah, nor was it necessary. His receiver won that route early, presented himself. No reason to wait. Go ahead and put it on him and score a touchdown.
Hauschka adds the extra point, and the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. Hauschka now to send this one away following the score. This is taken at the 3. And he'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. Watson and the Texans now down by 11. Less than 90 seconds to go. They need a touchdown with a two-point conversion and a field goal in either order as they've got it first down.
50 is set. 19, 58, right there. It's going to be a long
time. On first down, Watson. And that'll be incomplete. We do have a penalty flag down, however. Let's see what that's about. So now the story changes. Trailing in this one now. And time, a huge factor. How will this thing pan out? We'll watch as they come up on first down. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10.
Tight left, tight left. Four down.
To throw is Watson, operating from the gun. And that going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's one that has to absorb the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
Line of scrimmage, again the 37 as they line up second and 10.
I'm going back to you.
Throwing again is Watson. And his throw is incomplete.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open, and this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete. Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Watson now from the gun. He'll throw, and this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by Micah Hyde, and they have the football and will set up shop at the 33-yard line. The Bills on their way to victory now as they take the knee. Down to a knee, and that should just about do it.
Yeah, it's fun to kneel down in front of your home crowd, but when you go on the road, that band of brothers attitude, right, just us against the world, and get it done, How happy are they?
I remember a coach at a previous stop telling me, you get a win on the road, doesn't matter the opponent, get out of there like you stole something. And they did in this one. Charles, in this one, I think the storyline, really, the fourth quarter coming into it neck and neck, but they were able to separate, put their foot on the gas, and get the win.
And since you mentioned neck and neck, I'm going to stay with a little bit of a horse racing theme. It was that close, and then really went into the gallop and finished it strong.
One more horse racing theme.
Go.
I am glad you posted today.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
So that'll do it for my partner, Charles Davis, and the best darn crew in the industry. I'm Brandon Gaughton. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. So long, everybody.